Are you sure you're not the shaitan? Because you fell from Jenna. Yo, girl, I know I'm only allowed to marry 4, but you're a 10. I like your burqa. I'm wondering if I could talk you out of it. Girl, I need to break my fast. Can I have a date? Are you sure you're not the black stone? Because I just want to give you a big, slobbery kiss. Muhammad saw a woman walking down the street, and he started lusting after her. So he ran to the house of Zainab, a woman he married after breaking up her marriage by lusting after her.
Gotcha, bitch!
And Muhammad saw this woman walking down the street, and he had to run to Zainab for some relief. He already had somewhere between 9 and 11 wives, not counting his sex slaves. And Muslim sources report that he would have sex with all of his wives in one day. Sahih al-Bukhari, 5068. Narrated Anas, the Prophet used to go around, have sexual relations with all his wives in one night, and he had 9 wives.
Damn!
Sahih al-Bukhari, 5215. Narrated Anas bin Malik, the Prophet used to pass by, have sexual relation with, all his wives in one night, and at that time he had 9 wives.
Damn!
Sahih al-Bukhari, 268. Narrated Qatada, Anas bin Malik said, the Prophet used to visit all his wives and around, during the day and night, and they were 11 in number. I asked Anas, had the Prophet the strength for it? Anas replied, we used to say that the Prophet was given the strength of 30 men. And Saeed said, on the authority of Qatada, that Anas had told him about 9 wives only, not 11.
Damn!
Muhammad was having so much sex that his followers were bragging that he had the sexual strength of 30 men. And keep in mind, we're ignoring the sex he had with his slave girls. And yet, despite being the most oversexed man in the world, he couldn't see a woman walking down the street without going into a sexual frenzy and running to one of his wives.
I'm a hoe, I know I'm a hoe. I am. But don't you call me that little nigga that should come with the smoke. I'm a hoe, got bitches galore.
This is my empowerment. This is my liberation.
Who founded this religion? A man who would lose his mind when he saw a woman walking down the street. So, I ask the Muslim women who are watching, what's the real reason you cover yourselves? The real reason you cover yourselves is that your prophet couldn't control himself around women, so he demanded that women cover themselves. Muslim women have been covering themselves for 14 centuries because their religion was founded by history's greatest horn dog,